Oh, they're back, they're back, they're back, they're back, they're back. Oh. Hello. Are you back? I hadn't noticed. Well, good. Since you're back, you can bring some packages in. The delivery man left them by the side of the house. Oh, just a few things. Well, I ordered them online, of course. If I'd gone shopping, you would have known, because you would have been the one carrying them home from the store. And also the one driving me to the store. And also the one buying everything from the store. So, go ahead, bring them in. I've been waiting a very long time. Well, no, I hadn't noticed that you were gone. But I noticed that the package was still outside, so. Go, go. Oh, I only bought a few things. Well, yes, that one would be the 150-gallon fish tank. The fish will be here in a couple of days. Well, of course we need a fish tank. Where else are we going to keep the fish? Well, of course we need fish. What else am I going to do with those fishing poles that I bought? Of course, yes. I'm glad you understand now. Oh, that package is, that would be the 5-pound package of catnip that I got. Mm-hmm. No, I don't think it sounds like a lot. Do you think it sounds like a lot? Well, I mean, I'm hardly an addict. I could quit any time. But it makes me happy and I get bored. So, until those fish get here, that 5 pounds will do nicely. Well, yes, I do like that fishing game that you downloaded onto my tablet. That's what gave me the idea to go shopping for fishing rods. And also the fish and the fish tank. Oh, I didn't need money. No, I didn't. No, I didn't. I just tapped on the tablet until it sent the order. Well, yes, of course I realize it's being charged to you. I'm not stupid. No, I didn't. I said I don't need money. I didn't say that you don't need money. You need money. I can't think of any other reason why you would go to that boring job. It looks very boring. Speaking of your boring job, if you'll check that package right there. There you go. I got you something. Do you love it? Yes, of course it's a collar. You wear it. No, you wear it. No, you wear it. You wear the collar. I'm not the one who leaves the house. You could get lost. And see? It has my name and address on it, so they know where to return you. Well, quite frankly, no. I think you're very silly sometimes, and you could get lost. And not only that, but I have noticed that other humans are particularly stupid, and they don't recognize that you are owned. No, they don't even bother to smell you. How will they know that you're owned if they don't smell you? Well, Well, I might not have rubbed my scent glands on you per se in the past week, but I've scented your clothes every single day. Anyone who smelled you would know. But they don't bother to smell you. Humans are very stupid. What do you mean you won't wear a collar to work? Well, what do you mean I don't own you? Of course I own you. Scent, clothes, you, I own you. That's how it works. Well, do you have anyone else's scent on you? There. See? And frankly, I think even by human standards, I own you. Oh yes, because you're my mate. And once humans have a mate, they get to say things like, "That there's my man, and you better stay away from my man, you hussy." I learned it on TV. Frankly, I think the way we do it with a little bell on your collar is much more polite and far less harsh on the ears. All right, well, if it's the bell you object to, we can remove the bell. It's because it's pink. It's because it's pink, isn't it? All right, fine. Fine. Wearing a collar doesn't look professional. Fine. In that case, open up the next package. I thought you might feel this way. It's a tracking implant. I'm going to microchip you. Don't be silly. It's just a little prick. You won't even need any anesthesia for it. Well, now you're just being stubborn. I've been very flexible with the options here. I have to protect you. You are, as I understand it, a very high-value man. Someone might try to steal you. Well, your features are symmetrical. And you have a sense of humor. You're kind and patient, and you have a job, which I do not understand the appeal of, because it seems very boring. But other people like that you have a job, and a good one at that. You can afford lots and lots and lots of 150-gallon fish tanks for me. No? Well, then how many can you get for me? Well, perhaps you're not as high value as I thought you were. But still, you do have value on the market. The dating market. No, I don't think I watch too much TV. Why do you ask? Fine. Well, then, if you'll take a seat and roll up your sleeve, we'll get this implant. No. But I've explained to you why. I see. So what you're saying is that you're going to be unreasonable about this. No, I perfectly understand. That is your choice, and I will respect it, because we have been discussing respecting your choices, so I am respecting your choices. Even though you keep making stupid choices. Oh well, it's late. I'm very tired. Aren't you tired? Let's go to bed. There's nothing suspicious about that. I'm just very tired. See, I'm very tired. Ah, look, see, you just yawned as well. Let's go to bed. Come on. Let's go cuddle up in bed. I'll let you stroke my ears. That's very nice. Isn't it nice to just cuddle and go to sleep as you stroke my ears, as you fluff my tail? I'll be right back. You just sleep. What? Nothing. Nothing. No, I didn't try to tattoo you. Just go to sleep. You were dreaming. That is I got nothing. Not a single lie. Yes, I was trying to tattoo you. Oh, nothing. Just my name and our address on your bottom. If we move, are we moving? I don't want to move. I like it here. This is where my fish tank is. Oh. Well, I suppose if we moved, I would just scribble out the address and tattoo a new one on. I have to do something. I don't want to lose you. You're my human, and I love you. And I would be bothered if you weren't here to bring me food. And I love you. And sometimes when you're gone, I worry that you won't come back. And you go away for a very long time every day. And there are stupid humans out there who don't know rules. No, I don't worry about you liking somebody more than me. I mean, of course not. But I sometimes worry that you'll get lost or get hurt or somebody else will rub their scent all over you. Okay. What kind of compromise? On your phone? I'll be able to see where you are? No, I promise I won't come to your work. I wouldn't want to go to your work. Your work looks boring. Why? What happens at your work that you don't want me to see? Oh, of course. Yes. That would be very dangerous to anyone with a tail. Okay, well, GPS on your phone it is then. And I promise not to come by your work. Now, I suppose we can go to sleep now. Good night. No, I don't have any other ways to mark you or track you except for my scent. I promise. I already stuck the tracker into your favorite jacket anyway. Good night.